Fluid time entry in PeopleSoft Time and Labor provides a modern user interface with easy-to-use and intuitive pages for your time reporters. PeopleSoft HCM Update Image 27 has a new fluid timesheet with new rapid time entry pages. In addition, we have updated the look and feel of some existing fluid pages. PeopleSoft Time and Labor supports three different types of time reporters: elapsed time reporters, punch time reporters, and hourly time reporters. Elapsed time reporters only need to report the number of hours they work each day. Punch time reporters are hourly workers with a regular schedule of work hours. Hourly time reporters work the same hours daily or weekly and need to report the time worked rather than the quantity of hours. Elapsed time reporters can use the Enter Time page to enter time rapidly on a desktop system. While using a mobile device, it's easier to use the weekly time entry page to enter time-based existing schedules, prior time periods, or manual bulk time. Punch time reporters use the Report Time page to capture the punch format from a server while using a desktop computer, and they can easily use buttons for the punch type when using mobile devices. Hourly time reporters can use the Enter Time page to enter punch types on a desktop system. While using a mobile device, it's easier to use the Report Time page to enter time by punch format. Now, let's log in as an hourly time employee using a desktop system. From the Employee Self-Service page, open the Time tile. You can use the Enter Time page to log the time of your punch. The page opens to the current time period. Use the left and right arrows to scroll from one time period to another. Select the time period to see a calendar widget and choose another weekly time period. The Scheduled and Reported line shows your scheduled work hours and the hours that you have reported for that period. The legend shows you the icons used and the colors and patterns that appear on the status bar. The day summary gives information like the day and date, the status bar that represents the relationship between reported time and scheduled time, and your reported and scheduled hours for the day. Your organization configures the colors on the status bar. The punch types in the title bar below the time period are based on the punch pattern specified for each time reporter. The Show All Punch Columns button shows the punch types defined for your organization in addition to those assigned to the time reporter. Now, let's look at how an hourly time reporter enters their time using a mobile device. You can use the Report Time page for hourly time reporting. The date at the top of this page works in the same manner as the Enter Time page. In fact, all of the date fields at the top of Fluid Time and Labor pages work in the same way. The status bar is an addition to the Report Time page, so that this page is consistent with all Fluid Time pages. You can enter the time you want to record in the Time field. Your administrators enable the Time field on the Time Reporting template. When your organization configures the Time Reporting code, use the drop-down menu to select a code. The buttons at the bottom of the page show the next logical punch types. For example, your last action was to punch out, so the next logical punch is in, which is now the first button highlighted in green on the bar. Once you submit the in punch, it's no longer the next logical punch. Meal is now the next logical punch, and the first button highlighted in green. The system determines the next logical punch based on the time reporter's punch pattern. You can use the Actions menu to see the possible punch types and create a punch outside of the punch pattern. Now, let's look at how this page would be different for a true punch time reporter. Here, the system automatically records the time for every punch, so there is no time field. The page shows you the current time for informational purposes. Now, let's see how the Report Time page displays on a desktop system for a punch time reporter. Here, there are no punch type buttons. Instead, there's a drop-down list. You can select the punch type and save the time using the Submit button. Next, we'll log in as an elapsed time reporter. Elapsed time reporters can use two different pages for time entry. The first is the Enter Time page. This page looks similar to the hourly Enter Time page, except that the days display horizontally rather than vertically. The Quick Fill feature helps you to populate the Time Details fields on a timesheet. Quick Fill allows you to save a combination of values in the Time Details. Now, take a look at setting up and using Quick Fill. Select Setup Quick Fill from the left menu and choose Add to create a new Quick Fill. fill in the page, and save the quick fill with a unique name. You can come back to this page to edit or deactivate fields as needed. Now, when you enter time, the Quick Fill field drop-down lists the already saved quick fills. You can select it to populate the Time Details fields. We've updated the Weekly Time page and renamed it to the Weekly Time Summary page to make the page consistent with other fluid time entry pages. The changes include status bars at both the period and day level to indicate whether your reported time matches your schedule. Icons and status now let you know the approval status, if there is an exception, or special circumstances, such as an absence being reported. Selecting a day allows you to view, edit, delete, or add time. Now, if you're logging in using a mobile phone, you can rapidly enter the time using the Weekly Time Entry page. The Weekly Time Entry page allows you to populate time from a schedule, from the previous week, or manually. Select the days for which you want to report time, enter the appropriate fields, review your entries, and submit. Time reporters can now enter their time rapidly using the Time and Labor Fluid Time Entry pages on any device with a modern and simple user experience. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.